My presentation will be like a story, more of a story than code reading and showing. We will talk about canvas rendering for UX, and we will talk about how it started and how it went and what we did at the end. First of all, we were issuing some troubles with tiled rendering. You know, now Clover Online is rendering the document as tiles, 256 pixels in size, and the user then can interact with the tiles, and of course the users see the tiles next to each other and without gaps, so the document is seems like when you read it on the desktop version, and you can comfortably use it with Clover Online. So we were having troubles, having some issues with drawing the tiles onto screen, and because of CSS and HTML and rapid changing of the rules sometimes, and also we were having some troubles with rendering the UI fast, because you know, like in Calc, user can scroll the document very fast, and the document needs to answer it quickly. So at the end we decided to use a canvas for drawing the tiles instead of HTML elements, other image elements, and we also wanted to draw headers and row headers and column headers like the other similar things onto canvas, a canvas element. This journey began like this, and then we listed the advantages of using this, of course, before starting the work. Then we will we ended up with something like this list. Like implementation will be easy. It will be easier to maintain and improve, and we will have the same look in different devices, and we will be able to remove some third-party libraries. So it adds to maintainability, and it will be touch ready, and we wouldn't have to use canvas only for drawing. We will still be able to use HTML elements. So these were the benefits of the idea, and for the third party libraries, of course they are useful, but when they cannot couple with your code very good, then you may have some difficulties, or you may have a better idea or library which is created inside the company by you. And we are now using, of course, the canvas. And let me talk about the implementation. The tiles should be interactable. Users need to be, of course, able to click on them, scroll them, so the document. And at the end, we decided to centralize the event handling and drawings with a new class, which we call Canvas Section Container. We collected all these ideas and we tried, of course, because before this using this new class, and tested the idea. Then we created a new class which would be able to remove some third-party libraries that didn't work well with our code base, and we added simplifications and added some flexibility into our code, and now maintaining and improving the code base is easier, much more easier, I hope. We are still working on them, of course, working on them. And the idea we had and implemented at first place, the first version of it, was something like this. A UI designer on a canvas HTML element. And in this view, if user resizes the window, the scroll area or something else, text will be on the right again, and row headers will be on the left again. All the elements, all the sections, will keep their places relative to the screen. So we can now create row headers, column headers, and maybe in the future, a bottom section for calc tabs. We don't need them, but we could have them if we wanted to. And tiles, of course, in the middle of the screen and on the canvas. So and these sections, we call them section, will have their own files, and will have their own event handlers, and those events will be propagated from canvas section container itself. So canvas section container is the root of the event handling. So the event handling will be centralized. And diverse challenges, of course. For example, event propagation. A canvas element can, of course, get the events, handle the events, but and then it can send the event to the target section. Like in here, if mouse is on tiles section, then canvas element can catch that event and inform the tiles section that mouse is moving around it. Or row headers, of again, canvas element can handle that event and inform row headers section. But when we need a tiles section and a scroll section on top of each other, like a layered structure, then canvas section container needs to propagate the event to both of the sections. So this was one of the challenges we had, and then we added, of course, propagation feature to canvas section container. This picture shows that we are using propagate on click, and it propagates, it sends the same event to the sections one by one from top to bottom, and they can handle the event on their files, on their class structure. And one of the issues we had before canvas section container, multi-touch support with touch and mouse screen. You know, with some screens you can touch and the screen, and also you can use a mouse and keyboard. They are both enabled. So some libraries may have some difficulties with these devices. While we implement a new class, we also solved these issues and removed those third-party libraries and ensured that our new software works with devices, mouse and touch screen enabled at the same time. this is a view from the code, and that it's developed by us. And crisp images. This one, the most difficult one, and there's thanks to Michael and Candy for their patience, because it took a it took quite some time for me to understand what what they were talking about. So, and but the idea is simple at the end. I'm talking about. I hope you can hear me, right?
Yes. Yes.
Thank you. And the thing was now the latest software. It started with Chrome. At least I realized it with Chrome browser. There is a device pixel ratio feature now for some time, and with this device pixel ratio is higher in mobile devices and lower in general. I am generally speaking lower in desktop. It equals to one generally, and with this device pixel ratio, our images were smaller on mobile devices or were blurry, and that was the main issue we were having, because if it is blurry, it is not usable, and it was the main reason we wanted to use Canvas for drawing, and one of the main reasons with performance, of course. And so these our tiles were drawn with half sized, and the solution was using more tiles, of course, and we used more tiles, and we rounded the pixels so every tile is positioned with integer pixels, not float ones, because if you use float pixels, float coordinates with pixels, then the images are blurry again, and it was difficult, yes. But it is easy to explain. I hope I could explain, but it was difficult to implement, and it was difficult to see the important points with a huge code base, of course. And at the end, we prepared something like this, like something you see in this view. And we have now our scroll bar with our third-party libraries and column headers and row headers drawn onto Canvas, of course, along with tiles, as you can see, and also cell cursor and many more things drawn onto Canvas. And they are manageable. They are using the centralized event handling on their each one of them their own section file, and it is published. Thank you for watching. That's all from me.